Things have gotten rowdy a few times over the years. But I don't know how rockstar I was. We were just partying.
Just partying, serving drinks for everybody.
I'll tell you the story behind the band name. This goes back to 2003. We've been a band for a little while now. And our original singer, John Hershey, was dating a girl in high school. They were both seniors. Her name was August. And he broke up with her right before the summer. And she took it very badly and was honestly a bit of a psycho. And she went up the long lane that he lived up with his parents at. And his dog was in like a doghouse that they had. At night they put him in this doghouse that was fenced in. And she locked the dog in and burned the doghouse down and killed his dog, whose name was Red. It was an Irish setter named Red. So the band name August Burns Red comes from that horrific story, but we didn't change the name.
The legend lives on.
I'll tell you what gets me the most hype before a show. On like a festival like Greenfield here, watching another band that I think is a cool band play and watching like the crowd get real stoked on a band will hype me up just by watching me like sweet, I'm gonna go do that too. Like, let's go do this. That'll hype me up.
I'm hyped up just by being here and surrounded by these mountains, like just looking around and I'm awake, I'm ready to play already, you know, I wanna go. So that hypes me up today, at least. Music video started with the idea of having a very colorful, psychedelic video almost. I had the idea of an underwater music video, and we met with Drew Russ, who kind of, I talked to him on the phone before he shot, and he accelerated my idea and added so much more to it, you know, like getting eaten by a whale was his idea. Toxic waste turning us into mermen. You know, when I spoke to him, I just said, like, I thought it'd be cool to have like a shipwreck in an underwater music video scene. I thought it'd be really cool to play underwater. And, you know, we talked about it for a while and he came back and was like, what about this? What about that? And kind of accelerated it, my idea from there. I think the most rock star thing that maybe we've ever done is take over the bar, get behind the bar, and start serving drinks until we get in trouble. Like, no, you can't do that. You can't serve drinks.
Things have gotten rowdy a few times over the years, but I don't know how rock star I was. We were just partying.
Just partying, serving drinks for everybody. We all write lyrics, we all contribute, and we kind of have this system where we each will vote on the song anonymously, not knowing who wrote the song. And then we'll get together and pick the highest scored lyrics. It's been like that for a while. We've done that for,
yeah.
Haven't always done that, but all of the more recent records, the last three maybe?
It's very democratic.
Yeah, and there was a lot of material for the last record too. We read through probably 20-some songs.
Yeah. For the 12 songs that are on the
album. Which is a good problem to have, you know?
I got a cool gift on a tour. It was actually in Chicago, the last time we played Chicago at the end of 2015. We were doing a meet and greet and a fan came out with a quilt for my cat,
oh,
a cat
that
quilt that had like my cat's name like embroidered onto it, and it was just this quilt for my cat to lay on, like a small cat quilt. So that was a cool gift, I thought.
You get a lot of drawings and like posters and stuff. I remember that this kid made me a poster with your guitar on it. I feel like it had my bass on it. It might have had Brent's FR on it. And it said Carpe Diem, but it had,
oh yeah,
what was the quote that was on it? Dustin giveth and Dustin taketh away. That's what it says.
Oh really?
Just
when you step on stage and the crowd is cool and you're playing your songs and you're just having that synergy with the audience, that is why I personally love touring. I mean, just that feeling is something you don't get from anywhere else.
I have to agree too. That's why we're out here, is to play shows, and I look forward to it every night. I love playing shows. I'm very fortunate that we get to travel the world doing it, so that's why I'm out here, and that's my favorite part of being out here.
There's a few places I'd like to go before we stop touring all the time. I really would like to play South Korea. I think that'd be cool. I've never been there. China and India, those three. We're going to South Africa in August for the first time. That's kind of a bucket list place for us. We've never played in Africa.
Yeah, it's gonna be cool. I'd like to play Antarctica for some scientists. I think that'd be really cool.
That would be cool. Just to get that seventh continent checked off.
Yeah. And then when we can travel through space, I'd like to go play in space for another race or something, another, you know, species. That'd be really cool for me.
Yeah, we're really
big. Let's take it next winter.
Great fan base there. When we started out, our music was just like balls to the walls, heavy metalcore, as many breakdowns as possible, like just, you know, it was like 100% intensity the whole time.
Hey, we're August Burns Red.
And for the latest business news, click here. Hey. No, up there.
This one?